Take the next stage under section 30. A resolution professional has presented a resolution plan to the committee of creditors for its approval. But the committee of creditors does not approve such plan after considering its feasibility, viability, and the requisite vote of not less than 66% of the voting share of the financial creditors is not obtained. As has been mentioned herein above, the first proviso to section 30 subsection 4 furnishes the answer, which is that all that can happen at this stage is to require this resolution professional to invite a fresh resolution plan within the time limit specified where no other resolution plan is available with him. It is clear that at this stage again, no application before the adjudicating authority could be entertained as there is no vested right or fundamental right in the resolution applicant, and in the resolution applicant to have its resolution plan approved, and as no adjudication has yet taken place. Para 81. If on the other hand, a resolution plan has been approved by the committee of creditors and has passed the muster before the adjudicating authority, this determination can be challenged before the appellate authority under section 61 and may further be challenged before Supreme Court under section 62. If there is a question of law arising out of such order within the time specified in 62, section 64 also makes it clear that the timelines that are to be adhered to by the NCLT and NCLAT are of great importance and that reasons must be recorded by either NCLT or NCLAT if the matter is not disposed of within the time limit specified. Section 60 subsection 5, when it speaks of NCLT having jurisdiction to entertain or dispose of any application or proceeding by or against the corporate debtor or the corporate person, does not invest the NCLT with the jurisdiction to interfere at an applicant's behest at the stage before the quasi-judicial determination made by the adjudicating authority. The non-substantic clause, section 65, is designed for a different purpose, to ensure that the NCLT alone has the jurisdiction when it comes to applications and proceedings by or against a corporate debtor covered by the code, making it clear no other forum has jurisdiction to entertain or dispose of such applications or proceedings. That point is well settled. Further, in para 33, the Binani Industries Limited versus Bank of Baroda issue was taken up, and there in that judgment, para 2, they have quoted here. Here what happened is the process document also will tell whenever the resolution professional after receiving for in the expression of interest stage issues a process document for those people who are interested, he may put a condition that the decision of the creditors is final, and whatever be the before things, it cannot be challenged. That is also is taken into consideration here. It appears that the process document was issued on 20th December 2017. Which inter alia stipulated general and qualitative parameters. It clearly indicated that committee of creditors will negotiate only with resolution applicant, which reveals the highest score based on the evaluation criteria and whose resolution plan is in compliance with the requirements of the INB code as confirmed by the resolution professional. We have dealt with the object of INB code as recorded above. The resolution professional as well as the committee of creditors are duty bound to ensure maximization of value within the time frame prescribed by the INB code. Further, they went to 34 para. Section 25(2)(h) provides invitation of prospective lenders, investors and any other persons to put forward a resolution plan. Submission of revised offer is in continuation of the resolution plan already submitted and accepted by the resolution professional. It is not in dispute that after invitation was called for, Ultratech Cement Limited submitted the revised resolution plan on 12th February 2008. This is with respect to the other case. That is well within the time. It is not the case of the Committee of Creditors that plan of Ultratech Cement Limited was in violation of Section 30, Subsection 2 of INB Code. So, two conditions on which grounds have been taken. One is they within the time they have set it. Second sense, not in violation of section 32. Within 12th February, it was open to the Committee of Creditors to notice the revised offer given by the Ultratech Limited. The Committee of Creditors has taken note of the revised offer given by the Rajputana Properties Private Limited on 7th March, but refused to notice the revised offer submitted by Ultratech Cement Limited much prior to the decision of Committee of Creditors. This is a discrimination. So the law well settled is, when somebody want to revise the offer and that is presented within the timeline set, and the next one, the offer, the order given is not in contravention of section 30, subsection 2 of the code, and the Committee of Creditors should take recognition, cognizance of that. They cannot consider one as yes and then another no. That is discriminatory. Now, it is clear that prior to the Committee of Creditors voting upon resolution plan, it is open to COC to call for and consider the improved financial offer. That also has been made very clear, in accordance with the statutory mandate to ensure value maximization. So, it is well settled law. And now we'll take you to para 49 and 50, the last of the thing. The adjudicating authority at the time of consideration of the approved resolution plan of Jindal Steel Working Steel will only ensure that all the stakeholders, particularly the operational creditors, treated similarly. There should not be any discrimination. That's all. This is the judgment delivered in this case, completely discussed. Thank you.